Greetings to the beloved members of the Hopewell Missionary Baptist Church. I pray that this message and communication finds you in good health and strength on today, and you are prospering even as much as your soul does prosper. We want to again thank God for the ability to worship on this past weekend in celebration of 161 years of God's faithfulness to this church family. We certainly appreciate the work of those who were in the beginning and the early stages of this church's ministry that were committed by faith to stand firm on those truths and establish something of which we are part of to this day. And so we want to do our part as we carry this legacy forward. We thank God for every pastor, every deacon, every mother, every choir member, every usher, every sound technician, every youth, every individual that's been a part of the makeup of this great church and this great body of believers here. Now, I say that to say this, as we move forward in this season in which we presently occupy, we're dealing with a lot of different challenges, challenges that are not going to go away because of the turn of a calendar or because we wish them away. They're going to go away because we have been given effectiveness by the Spirit of God to minister to those who are hurting, those who are bruised, those who are lost in sin. Even in this season, they are confined by their sadness, and all they know is their level of brokenness. And so we've been called to be hope in a well. Yes, indeed, we've been called to be joy, to bring joy, and to encourage through joy that we possess within our own selves. And I pray that we have found our niche, we found our place in the kingdom of God, and we're serving in that capacity. God has called us and gifted us for it. But if perhaps you have not, this is also an appeal to find that place. There are so many things. There's a multitude of things that God would require and demand of us in this season. To each his own. As we fill that space and occupy that place, God will be glorified. Make no mistake about it. If you're following God, he will be glorified. A couple of quick things. In the month of November, I do want to encourage you to be considerate of a return to Christian education in a midweek fashion on Wednesday evenings. We're looking at some things now. Some persons are working toward that. We don't know exactly what that's going to look like, but we are praying about it. We're sort of looking at the numbers, of course, in COVID, but we are intent on returning to those things in some capacity in the month of November. I thank God for the ability that we've had thus far to communicate through social media, and we praise God for the efforts that have gone into making that broadcast, those broadcasts, a reality each week. So that being said, also we want to encourage you to look out for those things in November. There's going to be some opportunities to minister in our community. Being led right now as to where those things will be. We want to be present because the holiday season, yes, brings joy. It brings a time of connection with family and friends, but for others, it brings a great sense of pain, frustration, and discouragement. So considering that, let's be prayerful and mindful that there are those among us, even inside of the family of faith here, that may have those same feelings and experience those same realities. So as we go forth, we're going to look at some weekends where we're out in the community doing some things, perhaps as giveaways to individuals in the community and just being present for prayer and finding out what needs do exist during this time. And I also want to remind you that we have an opportunity with the homeless shelter as the winter months do approach to be one who searches your closet and seeks and sees if there are things that you no longer wear that you wouldn't mind donating to one of those shelters so that someone will find clothing. The ultimate goal, as we met this week with some leaders in our community, is to have and produce housing for individuals. We're not looking at camps. We need housing for those persons. So we're working toward that. We're moving toward that. God is going to bless the city through the faithfulness of those who are working to have those things and be able to announce and share those things. And we will be able to participate in those things going forward. The other thing is redistricting. Redistricting does matter because it affects representation and it affects resources. And so if you have not had opportunity in the e-news, you will find information that concerns those dates for hearing. You don't have to speak. You can just be present to see what's going on, the information that's being shared, and wise yourself up on those things that are on the horizon. It does us good to have informed persons in our congregation that would know what's going on and effectively be able to minister to those things. I want to salute the 501c3 of this church for moving forward with several endeavors that we've had over the course of this year and even last year in the midst of the pandemic that did minister to individuals, even in this setting. God be praised for those things that went forth. We want to even strengthen those things going forth. So much is in the life of this great church that we have yet to tap into, yet to unlock. And I pray that God is going to do that in the coming seasons that we're in. Amen. Be in prayer for your church and your community. The last thing I want to share with you is that we want to remember those in prayer among us who have gone through bereavement and sickness. So many persons, too numerous to name each of you on here, but we certainly remember you in prayer. We also remember the family of Dr. Richard Showers, great community citizen, great leader in Huntsville that will be laid to rest this week. We certainly thank God for his life and even the connection that he has through some family members here at Hopewell. In all that we do, God be praised. There's so many things I would share with you. I'll try to share some more on Sunday in the worship service at the conclusion of the worship service. But above everything else, be blessed. Go forward to honor the Lord Jesus Christ with your life on today. Love you, praying for you always.